This is North Korea, a country between China and South Korea. It's considered one of the most isolated countries in the world today. These clips were used to showcase North Korea's military feats and its position as a regional power. But beneath the decorative and extravagant parade is a country that has forsaken its people and has committed one of the worst human rights violations today. Every day, citizens are marginalized and massacred by the leaders who run the country. Children starve to death from lack of food, and families are torn apart and sent to prison camps, where they're tortured and executed. New revelations about the human rights violation in North Korea came in 2014, showing us the cruel reality in which North Koreans live in today. However, as other issues surfaced around the world, this topic has been thrown into the media cycle and has never been seriously addressed again. Over the next couple of minutes, we're going to explore and cover the human rights violation that's going on today and what we can do to expose the serious issue that's affecting thousands every second.
And DPRK is totally against misusing human rights for regime change in the country.
In 2014, North Korean ambassador to UN denied that there was human rights violation in the country. In response to this allegation, North Korea claimed to have the most advantageous human rights system in the world. According to their 53,000-word report on their human rights law, its political system bestows upon its citizens priceless political integrity, and its economic system ensures people an independent, creative working life. I was able to interview someone who had the opportunity to experience the side of North Korea that the country wants us to see. The identity of the interviewee was kept anonymous for security reasons.
They try to show you the best of North Korea, right? And so they would never show us people on the streets, homeless people, starving children. What they would show us is flowers on the streets, mountains, the beauty of the ocean, right?
We know from testimonies given by North Korean defectors and satellite images of prison camps that this facade is a cover-up for the unspeakable horror going on in the country. As of 2014, 7.6 million people are suffering from malnutrition and starving to death. And between 80 to 120,000 prisoners are detained in prison camps. The United Nations Human Rights Council released drawings described by North Korean defectors of what human rights violation was like in the prison camps. People are subjected to cruel treatments and humiliation, and many go hungry and scavenge for rats, lizards, and snakes for food. Worse, if they're caught eating, they're brutally beaten or even put to death. People of all ages are also forced to watch public execution or risk being executed themselves. Here, two North Korean prisoners are being forced to trample on a pregnant woman, killing the baby inside of her.
I knew I was only a few miles away from one of their political prison camps there, and I know of what's, I've heard of what's going on, but I would never even dare to ask if we could go there because they wouldn't even acknowledge the presence of a camp like that.
오늘부터 너는 사람이 아니고 이름은 없고 그린다는 그거는 이루 그 상상도 못해. 우리 벗기고는 그 자세를 이렇게 하고 다리를 벌리고 이렇게 해서 앉았다 열다 섰다 백 번을 이렇게 넓적한 판자가 내가 때려서 그거 빨리 쪼개져야 돼요. 쪼개지지 않으면 나는 계속 맞아야 돼요. 그 판자가 쪼개져야 돼요. 쪼개져야 그 매가 끝나는 거예요.
I was born in a political prison camp in North Korea. I was expected to just do manual labor and to work. And I had no concept, I had no rights, I had no concept of what human rights were. I was destined to live and die in this prison camp. It's not comparable to any other nation in the world. Terrible human rights violations beyond anyone's imagination. Those things are happening in North Korea right now.
To escape the harsh reality of North Korea, citizens take the risk of escaping and defect to China by secretly crossing over the border. Those who are lucky enough make it over to China. But the ones who don't make it are killed on the spot or sent back to North Korea, where they're severely punished for deserting their motherland. However, for those who defect, life is similar, if not more hard in the new environment, as they suffer from post-traumatic stress and the heartbreak of being separated from their families in North Korea.
His mother and sister escaped to China looking for work.
My sister was sold to a man, but it was only because my mom thought it would be a better life for her than return to North Korea. This is important part of my story that I hope illustrates how difficult and desperate the life is, and how many North Korean mothers who are forced to make this kind of heartbreaking decisions.
At the time, she says she didn't even know what a North Korean defector meant. Desperate to return to her family, Kim says she pretended to be a North Korean spy, hoping to be deported, instead ending up in prison. She asks why. Why can't she come back? Why do we have to go through such suffering?
Every time I hear their stories, or people go through North Korea, I feel hopeless knowing that a murderous government is silently killing their people with the world turned back on them. As a South Korean, my heart is torn by the reality that my brothers and sisters live in. It's a burden that I feel like I must carry until they're given the same rights and freedom endowed to every human being. I pray that my brothers and sisters haven't lost hope for a better tomorrow, because even in the darkness, there is always light, and there is always hope. Today, there is a movement going on to make this issue more known. Organizations like Link is rescuing refugees and giving them a second chance in life. Refugees have become a beacon of hope by sharing their testimonies and shedding light to the human rights violation in North Korea. And the most important thing we can do is share this information. This issue has been sidelined by mainstream media for too long. Each second, people are dying, and each time we share, we can make a difference. Share this video, spread the word about human rights violation in North Korea, and make the situation more known. We have the power to change the lives of millions of people. We can't hear them right now. But they will hear us.